New details emerged on the mosque bombing in Pakistan. Authorities say the suicide bomber disguised himself as a policeman. They were previously at a loss as to how the suspect was able to enter the mosque inside the police compound in the city of Peshawar. The development came as several other suspects were nabbed by police. Officials vow more arrests will be made in the coming days. The bombing left 100 people dead, with 217 others injured. U.S. defense officials are tracking a suspected Chinese spy balloon hovering over American airspace. The Pentagon says it appeared to be surveilling nuclear weapon sites. The balloon flew over Montana, where some of the U.S.'s sensitive air bases and strategic missiles are located. Pentagon spokesperson Pat Ryder says the balloon does not present a military or physical threat to the public. He adds this is not the first time a similar balloon was seen over the U.S. Meanwhile, Canada says it's also monitoring a similar incident. Ottawa's defense ministry says the movements of a high-altitude surveillance balloon are being watched closely by authorities. It adds measures are being taken to ensure the security of the country's airspace. Meanwhile, the U.S. backs allowing Russian athletes to compete at next year's Olympics. But the Biden administration's support comes on the condition the athletes will participate in the games as neutrals. The U.S. also says that the athletes must be barred from displaying their national flags or emblems during their matches. Ukraine has called on the International Olympic Committee to prevent Russian and Belarusian athletes from joining the games over Moscow's invasion. But Russia has hit back, saying the Olympics must not be politicized. The sporting body, for its part, says it will look for a pathway for Russians to take part in the Summer Games. The 2024 Olympics will be held in Paris. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken expected to meet with Chinese President Xi Jinping during a visit to Beijing next week. America's top diplomat will be in China from February 5 to 6 as the two countries seek to amend their strained ties. The White House has said Russia's war in Ukraine will be among the things Blinken will discuss with Chinese officials. Washington has warned Beijing of consequences if it provides Moscow with weaponry to help the war. U.S.-China relations have been marked by tensions in the past years, particularly due to America's support for Taiwan, which China claims as its own. Cross-border travel between China and its special administrative regions is set to fully resume next week. Officials say daily travel quotas and COVID testing requirements will be lifted beginning February 6th. China's Hong Kong and Macau Affairs Office says group tours will also be allowed to return, while the number of customs checkpoints will return to pre-pandemic levels. The announcement came after Hong Kong launched a tourism campaign to encourage more visitors to the financial hub. That includes giving away 500,000 free airline tickets to lure visitors back to the city. China pushes back against a Philippine visit of U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin III. The Chinese embassy says America's military posture in the region escalates tension and undermines regional peace and stability. It also claims Austin smeared Beijing during his Manila visit to advance what it called Washington's anti-China political agenda.